Good Wednesday evening, everyone. I'm Fletcher Mackel. And 1 week from today, the Saints start training camp at their facility in Metairie. The Dennis Allen, Jameis Winston era officially kicks off. And while the head coach and the quarterback will get most of the attention, we have so many intriguing storylines to focus on. One position group of interest, the cornerbacks. We know perennial Pro Bowler Marshon Lattimore has one job locked down. But is Paulson Adebo a shoe-in to be the starter across from him? The Stanford University product was solid but not spectacular as a rookie, so Saints reporter Catherine Terrell says keep an eye on one of this year's top draft picks, former Tennessee Volunteer Alante Taylor.
I think Alante Taylor is a really exciting guy. You know, when he was drafted, all the fans said, well, why would you draft him when they have enough guys? How does he fit? And I think the Saints just see a pure talent in him. And then if you talk to him, he's so confident. And it kind of just comes through that this guy is ready to go. And Dennis Allen specifically called him out, which I think is a really good sign of hitting the ground running early.
And next Wednesday, we'll have a special Saints training camp production coming up at 6:30 on July 27th. We'll recap day one, the day one workout, and we'll preview the upcoming season with WDSU analyst Jim Mora and Lance Moore. College football now, day three of SEC football media days. Lots of Louisiana flavor so far. New LSU head coach Brian Kelly was on Monday, former Tigers leader Nick Saban on Tuesday, and today, former UL Lafayette head coach Billy Napier. Napier led the Raging Cajuns to unprecedented success the last 4 years, and he was actually a finalist for the LSU job that went to Kelly. In the end, Napier is happy he found a home in the swamp.
Brian's an unbelievable coach. Got nothing but respect for him, nothing but respect for LSU. So, you know, I'm focused on the University of Florida. But I would tell you this, I am so appreciative of the experience I had in that state, you know, in Lafayette, right? I mean, unbelievable experience. The people, the community, certainly the staff, and most importantly, the players.
Closer to home, the Southeastern Lions are coming off a playoff campaign in 2021, but they have a huge hole to fill at quarterback. Literally a huge hole. 6'7" QB Cole Kelly, who won the famed Walter Payton Award, is now in the NFL with the Washington Commanders. So who's next under center in Hammond, America? The top two candidates for the job are Cephas Johnson and Colby Suits.
Second and five, play action.
Cephas has the early lead right now, but Colby Suits is really, he's grown throughout the spring and summer. We're gonna take it with the quarterback position. We might play two, like you said. We're not afraid to do that. We want to take advantage of each other's strengths and then limit the weaknesses that they have, and that's what we're going to do.
Coming up Thursday on the WDSU Sports, we'll preview Southeastern's arch rivals, the Nicholls State Colonels, in their upcoming football season. And that's a look at sports. Stay with us, everyone. Sulla will be right back with your late night Lanyap.